What did you do when you were 21? That is the question with which I will begin our next segment, which is about an incredibly brave 21-year-old called Pritilata Waddedar, who sacrificed her life for India's freedom. If you're not from Bengal, chances are you've never heard of Pritilata. That's because her name doesn't appear as often as it should in our history books. It doesn't come up in the stories about inspired Indian revolutionaries that we hear while growing up. And so we thought on India's Independence Day, we can right that wrong and we can take a look at this remarkable life, which though was short, created significant ripples in India's history. Pritilata was born in 1911 in Chittagong. She was one of six siblings born to parents of very modest means. And ever since she was a child, she was academically very gifted. While in school, she was greatly inspired by the story of Rani Lakshmibai. And when she was in college in Dhaka, she joined a group called the Pali Sangh, which was a revolutionary group that provided combat training to young women. A major turning point in her life came when Pritilata went and met Master Da Shurjo Sen, who was then underground. Now, Shurjo Sen, of course, needs no introduction. He was one of the key architects of India's freedom struggle. He was a leader of the violent revolutionary activities centered around Chittagong at that time. When Pritilata met Shurjo Sen, she expressed a desire to join his young band of revolutionaries. She wanted to join the Indian Republican Army that he was building. The purpose of this army was to liberate the city of Chittagong, which was then a part of the Bengal Presidency. They wanted to liberate the city of Chittagong from British rule, and they thought that this act would then inspire nationwide uprisings. Shurjo Sen was hesitant at first because it was not common for women to be part of armed revolutionary activities, and he also faced resistance from the young men in his group. But Pritilata was persistent, and eventually Shurjo Sen set her up to a task. He asked her to go and meet his friend Ramkrishna Biswas, who was sentenced to death, and he was imprisoned in Calcutta's Alipur jail. Now, everybody knows it's not easy to meet a death row inmate. But Pritilata managed to meet Ramkrishna Biswas as many as 40 times, as has been recorded in a few places. And with this, she managed to convince Shurjo Sen that she was up to whatever challenge he had in mind for her to face. She just wanted to contribute to India's freedom struggle. And the young male revolutionaries in Shurjo Sen's group also realized that there were certain benefits of recruiting young women like Pritilata within their ranks. They could even transport firearms without arousing the suspicions of British officers, who would not check them as often as they would check a young man. And so she was welcomed within the group. Now, even while she carried on these revolutionary activities, she completed her graduation in philosophy from Calcutta's Bethune College. But the British administrators, who were a part of Calcutta University, withheld her certificate. Her graduation certificate was awarded posthumously as recently as 2012. Now, moving on to the events that would lead to her giving up her life for India's freedom struggle. First came the Chittagong Armory Raid. Now, this is one of the most glorious chapters of India's history. A lot of you may be familiar with it already. In April 1930, a young band of revolutionaries led by Shurjo Sen destroyed telegraph poles and cut off communication. They unfurled the Indian national flag and proclaimed a revolutionary provincial government. The next day's press carried big news reports of this event, and the British army was quick to respond. Many young revolutionaries died, many were arrested, many were sentenced to death. And the revolutionaries disbanded soon after this event, but it was only temporary. In the year 1931, they planned another attack, and this time it was on the European Club of Pahartali. Now, why did they choose the European Club? It was because on the gates of this club hung a notice that said, "Dogs and Indians not allowed." And this infuriated Pritilata. and her friends. They planned the attack. They received arms training for the attack. And on 24th September 1932, it was planned that the attack would be launched. Now, the attack was supposed to be helmed by Pritilata's friend Kalpana Datta, but she was arrested a week before the attack. And the responsibility of leading the charge fell on Pritilata's shoulders. So Pritilata and a group of mostly teenage young revolutionaries set the European Club building on fire and they started shooting from the outside. What they did not know was that there were armed British officers inside the club and they shot back. And in this crossfire, Pritilata sustained bullet wound injuries. She could feel the British officers closing in on her and she did not want to get arrested. So she took a spot of cyanide and she sacrificed her life. Now her body was found the next day and she's said to have dressed up in the garb of a Punjabi man. Even today, something of Pritilata's spirit, her sense of right and wrong, lives on. And any time the fabric of this vibrant democracy is under threat, we find a Pritilata from somewhere or the other raising her voice, courting prison sentences, and being willing to give up her present in the hope of a better future. And then we realize that someone like Pritilata is much bigger than a national or a regional icon. She's an idea. And so a fitting tribute to her may not be through building statues and naming streets after her. We need to live free, independent lives. And in the face of insurmountable odds, we have to keep our spine straight. So here's to living a fierce, brave life of dignity like Pritilata. As Rajesh Khanna says in the movie Anand, Zindagi lambi nahi, badi honi chahiye. And this is as big as life can get. So here's to Pritilata Waddedar. May we be a little bit more like